I shall have the pleasure of talking to you. A peace offering?
Why a peace offering?
For this intrusion.
Oh, you are always welcome.
You're very kind.
Please sit down, Mr. Havard.
Thank you. You mustn't blame me for disturbing you at this time. I had a message from your husband. A matter of great importance, it said. Now, I wonder what that could be.
Oh, I'm afraid I don't share all my husband's secrets. Well, not yet, anyway. But I'm sure he won't be long. Ah, Stathis, would you fetch a vase, please? And how's Mrs. Avram?
You know, it was only yesterday that she was saying, Kuros, I must ask that charming English girl to come down to the beach with me. Well, I told her not to disturb you until your honeymoon's over.
Well, you shouldn't have said that.
She said you got on together.
She's very nice.
Yes. I'm rather fond of her myself.
Is my wife home, Stathis?
Ah, there is your husband.
Hello, Greg.
Hello there, honey.
Sorry to have kept you, Mr. Avram.
I would have been happy to wait even longer. Mr. Benares, You do understand I can do nothing more to help your people.
Oh, I'm not so sure of that.
But it's been explained to you already
that... inside. Perhaps I can persuade you to change your mind.
Come in.
It would hardly help his position politically.
Thank you. That'll be fine.
The story of what happened would have been splashed all over the front page. So I think you'd better make up your mind to do exactly as I tell you.
What happened? No.
What is it, honey?
Mr. Avram. He's dead.
What?
It says he took his own life.
Too bad.
When he left the house last night, he didn't even look at me. What were you two quarreling about?
It was nothing to do with this. Don't you believe me?
Yes. Of course.
Hey. You know, you're not looking well. This town's too hot. Can't have you getting sick, honey.
I'm going to take you away, man. Got to get the things packed.
When are we leaving?
Right away.
Recent picture.
Yes, taken in Athens.
He's self-made and unscrupulous to the point of being criminally dangerous if he doesn't get his own way.
You see that little cafe on the left there?
Yes, what about it?
They serve a wonderful kebab.
Now, Benares is a Bulgarian. He always affects a great display of wealth.
Very nice, too. Who's she? She looks pretty young.
An English girl. He married her about a month ago.
Good taste there, anyway. What's he do?
He graces himself with the title of financial advisor to the Zybek government. Financial extortion will be nearer the mark. He's negotiated several loans from the West, and they have all been misappropriated. Al Zybek and his cabinet live off the fat of the land. The peasant population remain, as always, in a state of appalling poverty.
If we're foolish enough to make the loans...
Well, we suspect Benares of using ruthless and illegal methods to force them through. Here's a case. An important minister grants them a loan and is forced to retire. Another country, loan granted and top-ranking public servant goes to prison. And another, a high government official kills himself.
Bribery and corruption.
Blackmail and extortion.
I'd like to have a go at him.
Oh,
Oh, you shall. We've just had news that Benares and his wife are going to live in Rome. Now, I've got a very interesting cover for you. It will call for a great deal of discipline. Now, you're a proud man. You will find this a salutary exercise. Oh, by the way, I'm dining the Fieldings on Thursday night.
The Roman antiquities. I hope I'm not invited, sir.
Oh, no. No, you're not invited, Drake. But you'll be there. And in the meantime, you're going back to school. And tell me, what are your plans for the winter?
London, I'm afraid.
Did you find it cold?
Oh, we've come to the melancholy conclusion that there's nowhere warm in Europe in the winter. So it might as well be London.
Well, if others can endure it, we can.
Oh, bravo, bravo.
You're pulling my leg, Bill.
Oh, you see, I've always had the deepest sympathy for the problems of the rich. Tell me, what about your beautiful palazzo in Rome?
Such luck. Found a perfect tenant.
Mm-hmm. And his name is Gregore Benares.
How on earth did you know?
How did you think, my dear?
Yes, we want to know a lot more about your perfect tenant.
Nothing wrong, is there?
Oh, no, not from your point of view. He'll pay the rent and take care of the house.
Well, that shouldn't be difficult. I've left him a first-class staff of servants.
And Hesketh, of course.
Oh, yes. Yes, the perfect English butler. Which brings me to my request. Our people would like to make a secret probe of Benares' affairs. So what we'd very much like to do is to put our man into your villa in place of your own.
Oh, Bill, I don't like the idea of one of your men running our house the least bit.
Oh? Well, what about Drake,
sir?
May I present Mr. Drake, Lady Caroline and Sir Charles Fielding.
How do you do, Lady Fielding? How do you do, Sir Charles?
Well, you certainly had me fooled. How do you do, Drake? I don't think we ever met. I was before your time.
Sit down, Drake. Pour yourself some wine.
Thank you, sir.
Well, Caroline?
Well, what can I say?
Good evening, sir. I trust you had a pleasant journey.
Fine, thanks. Drake?
Sir.
This is Mrs. Benares.
How do you do, madam? This way, please.
I hope you'll be very happy here, madam.
Thank you, Mr. Drake.
Just Drake, honey. Oh, and Drake, this is Josef. He has a comfortable room.
I've already done that, sir.
Oh, you have? Well, we'll let Josef make up his mind about that, huh? Oh, and Drake, don't go throwing your weight around with Josef. He takes his orders from me.
Just as you wish.
Ah, that's great. I hope you fellows get on well together.
I hope so, sir.
Well, let's see what I'm spending $1,500 a month on.
This way, madam.
Oh, that will do.
Oh, Greg, it's wonderful. It's like walking into another world.
It is it, honey? I'm glad you're pleased. My wife is a connoisseur, Drake.
Really, Greg? I wouldn't want Mr. Drake to think that
What Drake thinks is his business. What he does or does not do is ours.
I hope there's nothing I've forgotten, sir.
Nothing that can't be put right, but I would have liked all the servants to have welcomed Mrs. Benares on our arrival.
Oh, but Greg, I wouldn't want
It's a pleasant and civilized custom, honey. Perhaps you haven't come across it, Drake.
Oh, yes, indeed I have, sir. In the cinema.
What exactly do you mean by that?
Forgive me, sir. I didn't wish to be facetious.
I'm glad to hear that, Drake. I'm the one who makes the cracks round here, and you're the one who laughs. And now Mrs. Benares would appreciate it if you'd fetch up the staff right away. She's not a particular fan of the cinema, but she would care to observe the common courtesy of saying hello to the people who are going to serve her.
Of course.
Oh, and Drake. I expect you've been used to having things all your own way around here. I tell you what we'll do. We'll make a fresh start. From now on, we'll do things my way. And then everyone will be happy.
I shall run the house in whatever way Madam wishes, sir.
Yes. You do that. Oh, and Drake. I shall be entertaining some very important people. I want the best for my guests.
We are accustomed to entertaining important people, sir.
That's fine. Because on Tuesday, I'm expecting a very important dinner guest.
I shall consult with Madam in the morning, sir, regarding the menu.
Come in.
I hope I'm not disturbing you, madam.
Of course not.
Have you time now to discuss the menu for tomorrow, madam?
Yes. But I was hoping I could leave it to you.
Just as you wish, madam. Finished, madam?
Yes, thank you. The dinner must be rather special. We're expecting Mr. Armstrong and his daughter. Gregory says he's important.
Oh, yes, indeed, madam. He's an advisor to the cabinet, a prominent banker. You can leave it to me, ma'am.
Mr. Drake, I hope I'm not going to be a disappointment to you.
Madam?
I'm really a fraud.
I find that difficult to believe, madam.
Well, I'm not used to this kind of life, and I'm not very good at pretending.
Well, we're all frauds in one way or another. I can't imagine why you should have to pretend.
Well, you see, it's only a few weeks since I married Greg, and before that, well, I just didn't live this kind of life.
If you will forgive me for saying so, madam, you are beautiful, you have exceptional dignity, you are, as the Romans say, simpatico. I can't think why you should have anything to worry about.
Thank you, Mr. Drake. You fill me with confidence.
And now, madam, how about that dinner?
What do you think will be right?
Well, I would suggest for the main course a Bacio di Campagna. It's young lamb from the country. It's at its very best just now. Before the lamb, how about some trout? Blue trout from the mountain, served in almond sauce. And the asparagus in the market is excellent just now. We could start with that and finish with wild strawberries. They are brought in fresh from the hills every day.
That's not a dinner. That's poetry.
You think it will do, madam?
Oh, I'm sure it will. I can see I have an ally, Mr. Drake.
Oh, yes. You can count on me, madam.
So there you are, Drake.
Were you looking for me, sir?
I was.
What can I do for you, sir?
About tomorrow night.
Yes, I've just been discussing the menu with madam, sir.
Oh, you have?
Greg, darling, Mr. Drake has the most wonderful ideas.
Why, that's fine, honey. They must be pretty good. Helen doesn't usually show such enthusiasm.
Oh, really, darling, I hope I'm not as bad as all that.
You're not bad at all, honey. In fact, you're my favorite dish. What were you planning, Drake?
Well, I was suggesting for the main course, sir, a Bacio di Campagna, which is rather
May
nice.
I see that?
Thank you, sir.
Oh, Joseph, come into the bedroom, will you? Ah, come in, Joseph. About tomorrow, I want you to call London and have them fly us in some Scotch lobsters. Now for a main course, pheasant.
Excuse me, sir. Pheasant is out of season just now.
Is that so, Drake?
Yes, sir.
Right, Joseph. Call Johannesburg, Lindley's. Ask them to put some pheasants on the plane for us. And then we can start with caviar, and the rest of it I can work out later. Thank you, Joseph. Any objections, Drake?
No, sir.
Then you may go.
Thank you, sir.
I hope you're not going to make a habit of entertaining the staff in bed.
Don't be silly, darling.
Handsome looking guy, Drake, isn't he?
No!
Ago, the Orsini could have been dining right here on this terrace. That's something, huh?
Not on lobster and pheasant, though.
And people say things don't improve.
One of Rome's historic houses. All authentic, of course. 15th century.
I'm surprised that Lady Fielding agreed to lease you her treasure house. You must have great powers of persuasion.
Money can be persuasive.
You believe in making yourself comfortable?
When I was your age, honey, I had to live rough. Today, I'm not a poor man. I can afford a few comforts.
How clever you are to have chosen a rich as well as handsome husband, Mrs. Bernard.
Oh, I have no choice. Not with Greg. He chose me. But please call me Helen. I was reading that you're soon to be married, Judy.
Yes. He's not rich. But he's handsome and rather nice.
It's a funny thing, but I always thought I'd hate the young man who came to steal my daughter from me. But when I met him, he was just everything I could have wanted. And now, you know, I really think I like him better than her.
You see, I have good taste, haven't I?
Not always. Now perhaps you're glad I scared off all the others.
You make a perfect father.
Thank you, darling. Then it was worth all the tears.
This policeman they gave father is a security guard. He goes out with us at night. Well, that's when there's nothing official on. He takes us to places that tourists never see. But then you're lucky you live here, sir.
Oh, I haven't seen much of Rome yet. I must find you that picture.
Coffee, ma'am?
Thank you.
Cream?
No. Do you like being a butler, Drake?
I've never really thought about it, madam.
Well, I would if I were you. It's a dreadfully stuffy job, and you don't look stuffy. You know, I think you're wasted here.
Thank you, madam.
No sugar.
Liqueur, madam?
No, no. Suppose you could say you're a success. You have reached the top of your profession.
Yes, madam.
Then it's time to get out.
Thank you.
Here you are, Judy. Such a lovely picture of you.
Coffee, ma'am?
Well, thank you, Mr. Drake.
Mm. A bit self-conscious, wouldn't you say?
How long are you going to be in Rome?
A week or two.
Is your fiancé coming out?
Oh, no, worse luck. But I've got father to look after. And the clothes are absolutely wonderful in Rome.
It was nice hearing from my friend Sandra. How is he these days?
Still shaking the money tree.
As always. He said you would tell me about some proposal your government wishes to make us.
Well, no. It's not the government, exactly. That would be all, Drake.
Well, nothing else I can get you, sir?
No, thank you.
Sandro's really onto something this time. He's bought himself the controlling shares in INC.
Who are they?
One of our leading construction companies. They went through bad times. Sandro bought them in for peanuts through friends in power. He's got himself an option on the whole of the Carsian Peninsula.
The Carsian? Mm-hmm. What a beautiful stretch of coast that is. Or perhaps I should say was.
Just you wait till Sandro's finished with it. There'll be hotels, apartment blocks, yacht harbors. A Riviera to rival anything in the world.
How sad. But this is news to me.
Well, it's been a well-kept secret. It'll bring the tourists in millions, rich tourists with foreign currency. Just what our people need.
Shares in the company.
Not on the open market. But if you're interested, Sandro will arrange for you to pick up a large block of his shares. Not in your name, of course. And he's prepared to extend a year's credit.
So that before I had to pay, I would have doubled my money.
Doubled? Better than that, I hope.
It's very kind of Sandro. He'll need to pump a great deal of money into the company. Where's that coming from?
No problem. Our government will lend it.
Where will they get it?
No problem either. When they receive the new loan...
The loan they've requested from us.
That's right.
But we're not granting the loan.
You're joking.
I've advised against it.
I don't believe it.
You already knew it. That's why you're making me this princely offer.
You can rely completely on our discretion. Surely you're not going to throw away a fortune.
Mr. Benares. Our object in lending your country money has been to raise the status of your peasants. Very little, if any, seems to have been spent to that purpose. Your government seems to have found more attractive ways of squandering our loans.
You misjudge us. And with a thriving tourist trade, we'll soon be in a position to...
Then I wish you luck, Mr. Benares. And thank you for your splendid hospitality. I still have work to do before I go to bed.
But it's great fun. We must all go together.
Oh, we're not doing anything on Friday.
Right, that's fine then.
Oh, hold on, Armstrong. You're making a mistake.
Am I? Anytime your people wish to approach me officially to discuss land reform, I'll be very happy to meet them. And now, if you'll excuse us, Mrs. Benares. Come along, my dear. It's time we were home.
Drake, where the devil's Drake? But I'm sure Armstrong, if you give me another 10 minutes, I could convince you about the loan.
Well, I haven't seen much of Rome yet. I must find you that picture. Thank you.
By the way, Father, I've asked Helen if she and Mr. Benares can come on Friday evening.
That would be very nice, but I'm afraid it's not possible. We have another engagement. Judy's a bad child. She never asks me first.
You see, Helen, I never can please him.
Come along, my dear. Good night, Mrs. Benares. Thank you for a very pleasant evening.
Good night. Good night. Greg.
Mm-hmm.
What happened between you two?
Why, what do you mean?
Why did he go off like that?
He had work to do.
You quarreled.
Look, it's time for bed, honey.
But why?
Look, let's forget about it, shall we?
Greg, I like them.
What, that pious boor?
Yes, and Judy. I like her very much.
Oh, the delinquent daughter. I thought she was going to eat Drake alive. Must you hang about there?
I'm sorry, sir. Just locking up.
Oh, I know now. We'll never have any friends.
If you want to get on with people like that, you'd better get Drake to instruct you in the social graces in 6 easy lessons.
That's not fair, Greg. I didn't do so badly.
I thought that everything went off splendidly, madam.
Oh, you did you? And who asked your opinion?
No one, sir.
No, Drake. They didn't, did they?
Yes.
I was an only child, you see. My parents were quite old, and then they died, and I was alone. An awful little idiot. I just never learned how to get along with people.
I've never noticed it, madam. It must all be in your imagination. Pronto? Il residencia Benares? Just one moment, madam. I'll see. It's Miss Armstrong.
Oh, thank you. Good morning, Judy.
Oh, hello, Helen. I just wanted to say how much we enjoyed ourselves last night.
Oh, I'm so glad. I'm sorry Father couldn't make Friday.
Yes, it would have been fun.
Some other time,
I'll look forward to it. Oh, Helen,
I'm going shopping this afternoon. I suppose you wouldn't have time to come along and advise me.
Well, I'd love to, but... Well, I hardly know the shops in Rome.
Never mind. We can explore them together. Or would it be a drag?
No, I'll bring the car. 4 o'clock, then. Fine. Bye. Hello, Greg. That was Judy.
Oh, yes?
I said I'd go shopping with her this afternoon.
Good idea.
I thought I'd take the car.
Fine, honey.
Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon.
You're looking extremely chic, if I may say so.
You may, Mr. Drayton. Thank you. Where's the car?
I told you I have to be here at 5 to 4. Strange, he's not there.
Oh, Greg, we can't find Yosef.
No, that's right. He has gone to the airport to pick up a parcel for me.
But you've forgotten. He was taking us shopping.
Oh, I didn't tell you. Miss Armstrong phoned, asked you, would you make it another day? I said, yes, you'd be looking forward to that. Well, I'm right, aren't I? You did want to see her again.
Yes. I wanted to see her.
Can I speak to Miss Armstrong?
This is Miss Armstrong.
Mrs. Benares asked me to apologize. She's not quite finished at the hairdresser's. At the car downstairs, madame. She asked if you'd meet her there.
Yes, of course. I'll be right down.
He says Mrs. Benares has already left. Should have called to make it a shop around the corner. He'll show us where it is.
Okay.
Mi scusi, signorina.
Thank you. It's very kind of you to show us the way.
Sono privilegiato di accompagnarla.
Joseph, what's that smell? Like Eva?
Pronto? In residencia Benares. Yes, sir. I'll inquire, sir. Mr. Armstrong wishes to speak to Mrs. Benares. Yes, sir.
Good evening, Mr. Armstrong.
Forgive me for ringing at this hour, Mrs. Benares. Is my daughter with you?
No, she's not here.
What time did she leave?
Well, she hasn't been here.
But you were going out shopping together.
No, Mr. Armstrong, she rang and put me off.
Really? Well, I'm sorry to have bothered you.
Well, that's all right. I hope she turns up soon.
Good night.
Good night.
Out on the dials?
He seems awfully worried.
He should be used to it by now. Why did he phone us?
He thought perhaps she was with me.
Looking for something?
Yes.
And what's that?
Something that Mrs. Bernardes has mislaid.
It's the cleaning spirit you can smell. There's a mark on the upholstery.
I can't smell anything.
Can't you? Next time something is lost, Mr. Drake, perhaps you'll tell me. And keep out of my garage.
I'm sorry, I didn't realize you had anything to hide. Lighter, madam. Slip down behind the seat of the car.
Thank you, Mr. Drake.
Pleasure, ma'am.
Drake.
Yes, sir.
Come over here, Drake. Pour me a whiskey.
Certainly, sir.
How would you assess yourself as a servant, Drake? Would you say you're a good servant? I asked you a question, Drake.
Greg, please.
As a servant is a person who gives service, who is servile. You get no marks for servility, Drake.
How do you like your whiskey, sir?
50-50. I cannot understand a man wanting to do a job for which he has no aptitude.
Be all, sir.
No, Drake, that will not be all. I said 50-50. You've drowned it. Pour me another one.
Yes. So?
You'd like to throw that glass right in my face, wouldn't you, Drake? Why don't you? You know, Drake, I really believe I'm beginning to teach you the meaning of the word, servility.
You've got yourself.
It's nothing, madam.
No, you must go and put a dressing on it.
This will be adequate for the time being, madam.
Thank you, Drake. Tell me, how much does it take to persuade you you're not wanted here?
Even if I wanted to leave, sir, I would be unable to do so.
No? What's keeping you?
The house is in my charge, sir. I am responsible to Sir Charles.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll write to Sir Charles and tell him I don't like you and you don't give satisfaction.
I suggest you do that, sir. Will there be anything else, sir?
No, Drake, no. That'll be all. For the night.
Good night, madam.
Mr. Drake, I can't say how sorry I am, but tonight, Greg...
Please don't distress yourself on my account, madam.
But your hand. You must do something about that.
It will be all right.
Now, isn't that cute? Holding hands with the help.
Oh, Greg, this is idiotic.
Yes? Well, we'll talk about it later when I come upstairs. Go on, up with you, upstairs. Go on, honey. All right, Drake, I know your type. Spotted when I first saw you.
Did you, sir? I'm sorry if I hadn't given you satisfaction, sir.
Don't press your luck, Drake. I thought I told you to go on and get upstairs. I
Mr. Benares, right away.
Good evening, Mr. Armstrong. I was just going to bed. What can I do for you?
I'll talk to you inside.
Something wrong?
You know there is. Drake.
Good evening, sir. I'll come in.
What does Mr. Benares want now?
I haven't come from Mr. Benares.
Why have you come then?
About your daughter.
So it's you?
No, it's not me.
What about her?
We've been trying to nail Mr. Benares for quite a while.
I don't understand.
This time he's gone too far.
What are you talking about?
We want him out of the way, in prison.
Who are you, Drake?
Call our ambassador. He'll vouch for me.
So you're one of them? Well, I have nothing to say to you. I'm tired. I want to go to bed, so if you wouldn't mind
getting
up.
You're not going to bed until we get your daughter back.
My daughter back? I don't understand you.
I think perhaps you do.
Mr. Armstrong, I may have used unconventional tactics to persuade you to approve the loan, but to accuse me of kidnapping your daughter, well, it's unthinkable. Tell me, what can I do to help you? You can return her immediately.
I wish I could.
You have no idea who fought.
A very good idea.
One of your associates. The loan is important to many other people besides me. You can't make me responsible for the action of lunatics. I do sympathize with their wish to do something about the disgraceful poverty of our people, but not this.
First you try to bribe me. Now it's extortion.
See, there's a limit to my patience. How many times do I have...
They have my daughter. They say that if I go to the police, they'll kill her.
You believe them?
Yes.
And the price of her return is the loan. You can't do it, you know.
Then will you tell me what I can do?
Go to the police.
No.
Then I must.
What have you got to lose? She's my daughter, Drake.
You can't handle this on your own.
But you can, eh?
Yes.
So long as you have Benares safely in jail, what does it matter what happens to Judy?
That security man of yours, Strotti, have you told him?
Yes. He agrees that it would be fatal for the priest to interfere until we have Judy back.
I'd like to talk to him.
Very well. He's at home now. I'll call him and tell him you're on the way over. Drake, you must promise me that you won't endanger Judy's life.
Her life is already endangered. Whatever we do is a gamble. How can I promise?
Aspetti,
Sergeant Stotti?
Si. Buonasera, Signor Drake.
Sir?
Signor Armstrong has already called me.
Good.
But come upstairs.
Had an idea on the way.
I hope you will not follow.
If Bananas is behind this, then he must have some way of contacting the hideout.
Can I offer you a drink, Signore?
No, thank you. I'm going straight home now. In 15 minutes' time, Armstrong will phone Benares and tell him that the police have found his daughter. Benares won't believe him. He'll try to find out whether he's lying or not. He'll make a move to contact the kidnappers. I'll be watching him. Tell Armstrong to phone in 15 minutes.
You will do nothing. Signora Armstrong is a friend of mine, and I will see that his daughter comes to no harm. Signora Drake, you are interfering dangerously with something which is none of your business. Keep out of this.
I can't.
You can and you will.
I'm as anxious to protect the girl as anyone else, but I'm being practical. Now tell Armstrong to phone.
Signora Drake, since you do not intend to be reasonable, we shall have to lock you up until this matter is concluded.
On what charge?
Breaking into this apartment. You are in this country under false pretenses. I know what you are. Your government cannot defend you.
That's right. In my business, you have to look after yourself.
You understand, sir.
Sorry to wake you, sir. Mr. Armstrong just rang. He wanted me to tell you that he has his daughter back.
Did you have to wake me up to tell me that?
I'm very sorry, sir. Mr. Armstrong said that you were extremely concerned and he wanted to put your mind at rest.
Oh, how kind of him. Where was she?
He didn't say, sir, but I understand it was the police who returned her home.
Well, next time you can wait till morning.
We hope there won't be a next time, sir.
What is it, Greg?
Go to bed.
Thank you.
both of us.
Drake, how can I thank you? Come on in.
No, I can't. I have to attend on Mr. Benares and Judy. Don't forget what I told you.
Oh, Drake. Any time you want an upstairs maid.
Oh, anything to oblige, ma'am.
Morning, Yosef. Going somewhere?
Mr. Benares wants to speak to you.
And I want to speak to him.
Good morning, ma'am.
Oh, Mr. Drake.
What's happening here?
I don't know.
Drake, come here.
Excuse me, madam. Morning, sir. Taking a holiday, sir.
Where were you last night?
What I do in my own time is my own business, sir.
Yes, well, while you were away, someone broke into the cellar.
Really, sir? I wonder who would do a thing like that.
I'd just like to make sure that nothing's been taken.
Well, let's go and look, shall we, sir?
We're leaving right away, honey. Go out and wait in the car, will you? Now, go on, run along, honey. We won't be a second.
How long will you be gone, sir? For good? After you, sir. Everything appears to be in order, sir.
Pour me a glass of wine, Drake, will you?
I'm afraid that this is not a reliable vintage, sir. What have you done with my equipment?
I removed it to make room for you. You don't fool me, Drake.
There you are, Yosef. Otherwise, the master will have had his chips.
We'll be right up, honey. Just go and wait in the car, huh?
But there are some men here. They're asking for you, Greg.
Some men?
I think that madam is referring to the police, sir.
You know, I'll miss him. Well, not because I'll have to work again, but he made me into something. And I'm just nothing again.
To me, you are a very real person.
Thank you.
Good morning, Miss Armstrong.
Good morning, Mr. Drake. Helen, we're going back to London today. Can we give you a lift?
Oh, yes, please. That'll be wonderful.
You'll have to hurry.
I'll fetch my things. Goodbye, John.
Goodbye, Helen.